Hello friends, so welcome back and now we will move with springs. In previous lecture we studied columns, then short columns and that all concepts, and now we will move with springs. So if you are facing any doubt regarding that lectures, you can ask me in comment box. And yes, today we will moving with springs, and in that we will study firstly the classification, after that the different stress formulas, and that all. After that we will again move to one another spring, that is leaf spring and all. Okay, so just stay tuned and watch full video. This is very informative video for you. So springs classification. So in case of classification, firstly we will move with three types. First is torsion spring, then next is bending spring, and next is combined bending plus torsion. Here bending plus torsion both phenomena will occur, which is the case of combined bending plus torsion. So in case of torsion, there is one type, that is closed coil helical spring. This is nothing but, just wait, this is nothing but spring. So if the spring is closed coil, this is already I have drawn here helical spring, and in that, if that spring is closed coil, then that type is torsion spring. And next is bending, so this is leaf spring, okay, which is nothing but likewise the different leaves will be there, and this kind of spring is leaf spring, which is acts on the principle of bending. And next is combined bending plus torsion. So here open coil helical spring, again helical spring, but only open coil spring. Okay, closed coil and open coil, if you want that that topic, then I will definitely make video on that. But if I am coming with that topic also in this, then that will the video will be bit larger. That's why I am not going into detail of that closed coil and open coil. Just you remember, which is nothing but if there is bending, then leaf spring. If there is torsion, then closed coil helical. And if there is combined bending and torsion, then in that case the spring will be nothing but open coil helical spring. Okay, so in this you have noted one word, that is nothing but helical spring. So again helical spring have two types, one is closed coil and another is open coil. So that helical spring, which have two types, first is closed coil, open coil. So closed coil, in case of closed coil, the helix angle, which is nothing but alpha, which will be very very small, okay, which will be very very small, and this will be subjected to torsion only. Only torsion will be there, no any case of bending. In case of closed coil spring, there will be only phenomena of torsion, there will no any case of bending. So this is nothing but closed coil, and helix angle alpha will very small, okay, means likewise the spring will be compact. And in case of open coil spring, the helix angle alpha will be large, so spring will be somehow likewise, okay. And next parameter is nothing but subjected to both bending plus torsion. Here bending plus torsion both phenomena will occur in case of open coil spring. Ultimately, if you know, if you are not getting, you can ask me in comment box. But that's all from the helical spring, that is nothing but closed coil and open coil. This is only the description, the formulae part is remaining that I am coming with. Just wait for that. Yeah, so closed coil helical spring subjected to axial load W. If this is closed coil helical spring and subjected to axial load W, this will be axis of that spring, and the axial load W is subjected onto that spring. So ultimately the torsion, which is equal to W into R. So W is nothing but axial load and R will nothing but radius of that spring, not the radius of the bar. Okay, radius of this spring, this is capital R. Total, this will be capital T and half of that will be capital R. So this is nothing but torsion. Then maximum shear stress, in this case the maximum shear stress will equal to 16WR divided by pi d cube. So this is also important formula, that is nothing but maximum shear stress equal to 16 times load into radius of spring divided by pi d cube. Again, this d is nothing but diameter of this, small diameter means wire diameter, we can say wire diameter. Okay, then next is spring index. There is one term that is nothing but spring index, and which is denoted by B, which is equal to capital D upon small d, means spring diameter to the wire diameter. This is nothing but spring index. This index is also important in some questions of tricky questions of gate and etc. They will ask you to calculate spring index, or they will give you the spring index and they will give you relation, another any relation between D and D, and they will ask you to calculate spring diameter or wire diameter. So that's why this formula is too much important. So note down this formula. And so next is nothing but equivalent length. Just wait, I will remove this. Equivalent length means if this wire from which the spring is made, the exact length of that wire, this is the length of spring, okay, but the length of wire will be different. Means if we are enlarging this to the straight wire, if we are unwinding this spring, then what will be the length? That is nothing but equivalent length, and that equivalent length will equal to which is equal to 2 pi r into n. So again, this r is nothing but this r, and n is number of coils. There are number of coils wound by this wire, and the spring is formed. So how much number of coils are there? For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here 6 coils I have drawn. Likewise, the n will vary. So this is formula for equivalent length. Equivalent length, which is equal to 2 pi r into n, and n is nothing but number of coils, or we can say number of turns. Proper word is number of turns. So note down this formula. And now next is strain energy stored in the coil. As this is coil, so in this coil, what amount of strain energy is stored because of torsion or because of different cases there. So because of torsion only here, as we are considering this kind of spring, which is torsion spring. So U of coil, which is equal to 32 W square R cube N divided by G d raised to 4. Again, 32 is constant, W is load, axial load, R is nothing but again our coil radius, and N is number of turns, G is modulus of rigidity, and D is again wire diameter. So this is nothing but strain energy stored in that coil while there is only torsion. We are considering only torsional spring, that is closed coiled helical spring. Okay, so these are all the formulas for closed coil helical spring. And then we will move towards another formula, that is deflection of spring due to this load. Because of this load, the spring will deflect in some amount. Ultimately, if we are applying load, then every action have equal and opposite reaction. So ultimately, because of this load, the spring will deflect, and that deflection we are going to calculate, which is equal to so the deflection delta, which is equal to 64 W R cube N divided by G d raised to 4. Okay, 64 W R cube N divided by G d raised to 4. This is nothing but formula for delta, which we can say W upon K, and so remaining parameter will be K, and K is nothing but spring constant or spring stiffness. This is spring constant or stiffness. We can say as a spring constant also or spring stiffness also. Spring stiffness is proper word for that. So that K will be, from this formula only we are going to derive this K. So K will be, K is on this side. So delta will come here. So that will be W upon delta. And from this formula the W will be removed and other term will be as it is. So G D raised to 4 upon 64 R cube N. So this is nothing but the formula for calculation of spring stiffness in case of closed coiled helical spring. Okay, so again this is coil diameter, this is coil radius, and we can change this formula to coil diameter also. And so ultimately that will become G D raised to 4 divided by 8 D cube N. Here I have replaced this R with D, so ultimately R is nothing but D by 2, so 2 cube means 8, so 8 is 64, so that's why there is 8 and all other terms are same. Okay, so this is nothing but K in terms of R, in terms of D, and in terms of W and tail. So these all three formulas are important. This formula is also important. This formula is also important. So please note down these all formulas, and we concluded with all the formulas of closed coiled helical spring. And now we will, okay, just wait, one formula is remaining there. Closed coiled helical spring subjected to axial couple. If this same closed coiled helical spring is subjected to axial couple, then there will be development of bending stress. Okay, because of axial couple, which is M, axial couple is nothing but bending moment. Couple is nothing but moment. So because of that axial couple, that is nothing but moment, the bending stress will develop, and that bending stress, which is we are going to denote with F, and which is equal to 32 M upon pi D cube. So this is formula for bending stress if the closed coiled helical spring is subjected to axial couple. So all formulas I have concluded here, but apart from this also, if you are facing any problem, you can ask me in comment box. And yeah, so we will move with now lip spring. So we concluded with closed coil helical spring, and now we will move with lip spring. Lip spring is nothing but such a kind of spring will be there. Okay, and this is point O, that is nothing but origin of the radius of this. Okay, and del 0 means initial deflection. Del 0 is nothing but initial deflection. This is L by 2. This is also L by 2. Okay, and load will be applied on these two points. So ultimately load will be segregated. So here W by 2 and here W by 2, as these both ends will be connected there. You may have seen this kind of spring in case of trucks and heavy vehicles. Okay, all heavy vehicles contains this kind of springs, and in previous springs what was happening there, because of torsion the energy was stored, the strain energy was stored into the spring. But here what will happen, because of friction action between two leaves, the bending the damping will happen, and ultimately the spring will function like that. Okay, because of friction between these two leaves, this is nothing but basic principle of working of this leaf spring. Okay, then so this is nothing but A, and what is that A? A is nothing but overhang distance. All values will be A from here to here, from here to here, all values will be A, and that are same. So just move with the formulas. I hope you understood this figure. If you are not understood, then you can ask me in comment box. I'll definitely try to explain you again. If n is the number of leaves, if n is number of leaves like 1, 2, 3, 4, I have considered here 4. If that number of leaves will be n, and that length of span, this is nothing but length of span, which is equal to capital L, and this is L by 2, that's not matter. So capital L is nothing but length of span of that whole spring. So ultimately, the A, that is nothing but overhang distance, will become L upon 2 times N. This is nothing but A, that is overhang distance will equal to length of span divided by 2 times number of leaves we have. This is nothing but number of leaves N. Then central deflection delta, this central deflection delta will equal to, this is initial deflection, that is delta 0, but after loading the deflection will change. So that delta will equal to 3 by 8 W L cube divided by N B T cube E. Okay. So what are the parameters here? That is nothing but 3 by 8, this is constant, W is load, L is nothing but length of span, then N number of leaves, then B nothing but width, and T is nothing but thickness. That cross section I am not showing here, but B is nothing but width and T is nothing but thickness, and E is nothing but modulus of elasticity of the material what we have used to make the leaves. So this is deflection formula. And then maximum bending stress, the maximum bending stress will equal to 3 times WL divided by N, 2 NBT square. Okay, so the maximum bending stress will equal to 3 times WL upon 2 NBT square. So this is maximum bending stress which this leaf can sustain. So in case of leaf spring, these are only the formulas, and these are only the formulas that are important in case of leaf springs. And what I have discussed for closed coiled helical spring, all important formulas I have discussed there. Okay, so don't forget to remember these, all the formulas. All formulas are important for any kind of exam like GATE or etc. And yes, that's all from today's lecture. And now we will move towards bonus point. Bonus point is so much important because in every cases you will in complicated cases you will see that springs will be in series or springs will be in parallel. Likewise, this is series, then this is parallel combination. So ultimately this is K1, K2. What is K1 and K2? Spring stiffness for spring 1, stiffness for spring 2. Okay, this is nothing but K1, K2. So for series connection, how we can calculate the equivalent K? Okay, that is nothing but K equivalent. So in case of series, that 1 upon K equivalent will equal to 1 upon K1 plus 1 upon K2. And in case of parallel, the K equivalent will equal to directly K1 plus K2. So these all the formulas are very much important to calculate the equivalent stiffness. Okay. So just note down these two formulas also. And in next lecture, I will come up with another topic. So just stay tuned for that. And if you have any difficulty, if you have any confusion, you can ask me in comment box. You can join me on Instagram also. Thank you friends. We'll meet again.